It's nice to have you back. Come with me. Today, we'll take a look at how ultrasonic and radar instruments cope with buildup in dirt and determine which measuring principle is better. Jürgen, we need your help again.
Of course, gladly. Let's have a look at a lift station today.
In many applications, sensors can get quite dirty. For example, in a lift station, where wastewater is pumped to the sewage treatment plant. This is where condensate, steam, dirt deposits, or even spider webs form, strongly influencing the measurement.
Here, we've simulated spider webs with synthetic fibers. The sound waves travel right through the spider webs when they're dry. But if condensate forms or further contamination collects on them, the measurement fails. Now, I'll simulate this effect with condensate and toilet paper on the sensor. With the radar sensor, the measured values remain stable. With the ultrasonic sensor, there are very strong fluctuations.
What does this mean for the measuring point?
In the worst-case scenario, the lift station overflows or the pumps run dry and are damaged.
So you have to choose, either clean the measuring instruments regularly,
or use a technology that works extraordinarily well.
Radar is simply the better ultrasonic. Check out the rest of the videos from the series Radar versus Ultrasonic.